The zoning board committee, roll call, please.
Neely.
Hahn.
Here.
Miller.
Yeah.
Johnston. Here. Reidenauer. Kaufman.
Here.
Earl.
Very good. Good evening, welcome to the public hearing before the Village of Waynesfield Zoning Board of Appeals regarding the zoning change requests submitted by Dollar General. Here tonight are the zoning board members and representatives of Dollar General. The format of tonight's proceeding will be as follows. Any person from the public who wishes to address the zoning board or to ask questions of the representatives must sign in on sign-in sheets. Once your name is called, please step to the podium, at which point you will have a maximum of 3 minutes to express your opinion or ask questions regarding the zoning change. Your time cannot be deferred to another individual. Please understand that for the purposes of the public ability to hear, only specific people will be granted the opportunity to speak. They are as follows. The person at the podium, the zoning board, including the mayor, Dollar General representatives, and legal counsel. Failure to abide by the rules may result in the removal from this hearing. Folks, we must maintain order, and I appreciate your cooperation doing this. Finally, let me reiterate. This hearing is for the proposed zoning change to allow Dollar General to build on a lot that is currently zoned agricultural that they have already purchased. Before we begin the public input portion of the meeting, I want to give Dollar General representative the opportunity to provide some opening remarks.
Good evening, my name is David Shear. My father and I own a small development company out of Florida. Some years ago, about two, Dollar General asked us to come up to Ohio and start building some stores for them, and we'll be willing to travel anywhere to help them out and establish a relationship with them. They had selected this town for Dollar General back in August, and I had visited the town several times and looked at several pieces of property to put up a Dollar General. After working with them, we have selected this site over here that everyone's aware of, and it is unfortunately zoned agriculture. We are looking to change that for the commercial zoning in order to build a Dollar General store in your town. We have gone ahead and started doing some preliminary site plans to give everyone an idea of what the store would look like. And here's one which will be happy to blow up. And here is, we have, if I may. Set one here for you all. And one for you all. The layout's essentially the same. We are still playing with the stormwater retention layout in order to make it as efficient as possible. This is one prototype here that is behind it. You'll see that the Dollar General is fairly set back. I'll pull up on the screen. The Dollar General is fairly set back from the local houses. We have gone ahead and established number 13 here on the screen is a privacy fence on the right side of the property in order to shield any traffic or noise from the neighbors that are directly adjacent to it, in addition to moving the building as far away from that property as feasible. We are conforming with all side setbacks as for the proposed usage, parking, and we look forward to coming to town and bringing a store for y'all to shop at.
All right, this will be the public input portion of the meeting. Please step to the podium when I call your name. You'll have 3 minutes to voice your concerns or opinions. We'll start with Dick Harden.
I'd like to start off by welcoming everybody tonight. I want to start by saying that I personally would like to see a store of any kind in Waynesfield. That being said, as a village council member, I have an obligation to the whole community to know and understand all aspects of any project that impacts the village as much as something like this. I have some major concerns about some costly infrastructure items that need to happen. I don't want to and can't make a decision on something this important without a lot more information than I have at this point. As a homeowner across the street from the proposed project in the direct path of storm runoff with a yard that floods with any substantial rain, I believe the problems will only get worse if you build a large building and a paved parking lot in the middle of a natural waterway. So at this time, I cannot support a zoning change. Thank you for your time.
Next we have Brian Harden.
Hey, let me open by saying first that I'm very much in favor of bringing the Dollar General to Waynesfield or any reputable retailer. What I'm opposed to is spot zoning. When zoning was first proposed in town over 30 years ago, two of its biggest proponents at the time were Neil Tussing and Ferris Earle. Nobody's going to argue with their stature in the community. Both told me at the time, we need zoning to attract business and protect homeowners' rights, and if we didn't have zoning, I could end up with a nightclub or a grocery store in my front yard. We're now being asked to modify that same law to allow just that scenario. On Wednesday morning, while watching the Senate confirmation hearings for Judge Neil Gorsuch, Senator Dianne Feinstein made a statement that struck me as profound. She said to Judge Gorsuch, people who advise, that would be all of you, have an obligation to find the truth. As recently as July the 25th, 2016, at the village council meeting, the village administrator, when asked by another citizen, Leatrice Runkle, about an unrelated property, the possibility of changing the zoning laws, the administrator informed Ms. Runkle and council, if zoning laws were changed, it would be for all agricultural / industrial properties, as spot zoning is not legal. Spot zoning is not without precedent in Waynesfield. Several years ago, a piece of property was rezoned from residential to commercial to allow for a rather innocuous home-based flower business. I did not oppose the change at that time, and under the same scenario, would not oppose it today. Unfortunately, that business failed, as some businesses do. Last summer, complaints were filed with the council about lack of mowing and weed control on that property. The complainants were told due to the property's commercial zoning, it only had to be mowed once per year. My concerns with the present situation is that we are allowing ourselves to be pushed in a direction that does not leave a way out. Dollar General has asked for this zoning change in order to bring a much needed retail outlet to our village. That is a point I have no reason or intention of disputing. My question to this board is this, the proper location for that outlet. Have you, as members of an advisory board, spoke to anyone who could adversely be affected by your decision? Have you consulted with engineers to determine the effect of additional runoff? If DG plans in developing 1.10 acres, why does the petition for rezoning involve 8.099 acres? If there are other plans for the rest of the property, that is another issue and should definitely be considered separately from the issue at hand. That's all I have.
Okay, Nellie?
No, they just told me I had to sign in.
Okay.
I didn't have to talk.
Nellie?
All I really have to say is actually this town has fell down behind some of the things years ago. These things could have been done and weren't done. We need something for the people in this town that'll work for them. And Dollar General has been very good in different areas. And I know that the one went in Huntsville, and they are doing fantastic there. And I know that not only me, but there'll be a lot of people that would shop at Dollar General. That's all I got to say.
Thank you very much. Hey, Randy, pardon?
I as well, as everybody in the community, is very in favor of this Dollar General. Hopefully it will spur additional development. I know it makes me consider additional development, as I'm own a fair amount of property in this area. But I want everybody to understand that this development needs to be approached correctly. There have been some mistakes in development in the past that some current property owners are paying dearly for right now. Also, please remember this building is going to be here for a very long time. But it's going to be wonderful for everybody in this area. And I have a few questions. David and I have worked on this project. David, I'm assuming you have not purchased this property.
That is correct, yes.
Correct. Mike, that was a misstatement.
Okay.
Were other sites considered in your exploring this town?
We were under contract to purchase one of your properties. We also considered property out by the gas station.
Can you definitively say that it is this site or nothing?
It's this site or nothing for the foreseeable future, and but I've been told by Dollar General.
Okay. I might add that Dollar General was on a pretty steep growth curve. They built about 900 stores last year. They want to build 1,000 stores this year. And in order to continue that, they're going to have to come to more urban areas like Waynesfield. Go to Lima, there's stores in a lot of places. So I think if it's not Dollar General, it could be Family Dollar or someplace else. But, I don't want to stand in the way of this. If it ends up wherever it needs to be, I'm in favor of that. But the property owners need to be able to participate and have due process and understand that there is a proper protest procedure that can be followed. They need to be made aware of that. And that then automatically, according to your zoning code, forces the ultimate decision to be made by the council. And it will require a 3/4 vote, which in our case is 5 of 6. To approve the spot zoning change. Again, I have nothing but good things to say about David and his company, and I'm sure they'll do a fine job wherever they put it in our community. Thanks.
Thanks very much. Barbara Mahler.
Huh? Oh, I ain't speaking. I thought it was speaking tonight. I'm all for it though. I mean, it is butt up right against my property. So he's talking about where it's going to be. I'm like, how close to my house? Yard line when I mow, how close is that going to be? That type. But,
okay,
hey,
Nicole Whitten, is that right?
Yes, that's right.
Okay. I am not very educated in zoning or runoff or anything like that, but I can say we've lived in Waynesfield for a little over a year. It's my husband and we have 3 young children. Right away, we loved the town. We loved the people at the gas station, the people at the post office, the school administration, everybody. But we were worried that we had just bought a house in a town that is very quickly dying as we look around. And I think that a Dollar General, not by itself, would help resurrect it, but it would be a good start, in my opinion. Because I can say where we live, Lima, Walpock, the lake are all exactly the same distance apart. So if I go to the grocery store for suppers for the week and I forget one thing, I have to drive all the way to the lake, to Lima or to Walpock to get the sour cream I forgot for tacos or whatever it's gonna be. And I think that a Dollar General would be awesome. High school kids could have summer jobs there. Me as a mom, when my kids go to school, I could get a part-time job there. I think it would be great. And that's all I have to say. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Nicole.
Eric, Vernon, want to say anything? Okay.
I didn't really want to speak, but yeah, we very much are for it. Wherever it's in Waynesfield, we know that it's really needed.
Okay, Shawna?
I have some questions with regards to the process that's being taken in this rezoning. The timeline. So I'm under the impression that revised code requires 30 days notice before this hearing is to be held. Do you have the date that this was printed in the newspaper that the rezoning would be going up for a vote?
The next day, it was in the newspaper by the press that was here that night.
Right.
And the next day, the chief of police posted on the website, which our attorneys have said in the past is an acceptable format of posting. And then we tried to get it in the newspaper as soon as we could, and I think it was a few days later. But I think the day after the council meeting, when Mr. Shearer was here, it was posted.
So the council meeting was March 3rd, correct? Correct.
Okay. I don't know the date, if that's what it was.
Okay, today's March 23rd.
The zoning board meeting was the 23rd.
23rd, the prior month.
Okay, but it has to be publicly posted 30 days prior to this meeting, correct?
Our attorney advised us it need to be 20 days.
The Ohio Revised Code, should you want me to read it?
I'm just telling you what my attorney said.
Okay.
Our attorney.
Ohio Revised Code shall give at least 30 days notice of the time and place thereof in a newspaper of general circulation. Not Facebook. I don't have Facebook, so I wouldn't have seen that. In the municipal corporation. So I'm concerned that this is not being approached in a legal manner, number one. Number two, as far as the letters that went out to the landowners go, now, originally it was posed that there was only going to be a small portion of that 8 acres, but it does sound like the whole 8 acres is being considered for rezoning.
That's incorrect.
That is incorrect?
That's incorrect.
Okay. Did you have the plat maps on file for the full 30 days?
I do know that it is plat number, there's two plat numbers, which is what, one point, how much acres is it?
I know the last time I checked, they were not on file the 30 days before, so I'll just say that. So just things that I feel, as a concerned citizen, that these are not being approached in a legal manner, I'd like to bring up.
Is it at 1.84 or 1.46 based on how we handle the stormwater.
And what date were these available on file?
These are current working development plans. Okay. I'm not sure how that relates to plats, as we are subdividing a piece of property from a larger plat. I'm not sure about the legal stance of that.
Last time I checked, it wasn't. It was just parcel numbers, which isn't the development plan that should be per the code, should have been on file. So I have concerns with that. And I guess I want to close with saying I think that I know this council tends to first, for whatever reason, it's recommended to vote things in a rush a lot, and I think this is a really important matter, something we can't unring this bell once it's done. That building will be there forever. I mean, hope for the best, but plan for the worst. If it were to fail, then we need another vacant commercial property. So let's take our time, vote it through thoroughly, and consider all aspects and ramifications.
Thank you. Scott Titan?
I don't have a lot more to add. I think Randy spoke a lot in what I had to say. I think it'd be great for this community to have something. I think it's the absolute wrong place to do it. And can I ask you what, you said you had a couple different other places to choose from. What made you guys choose that site over, you know?
How about the gas station wanted an exorbitant amount of money? That Dollar General was not willing to pay. Mr. Carr and I did put a piece of property under contract together further north over by the industrial park, but it was too far away from the intersection for Dollar General to consider. So those are what I'm being told from Dollar General, who I ultimately end up working for. They really like this site and they really want to be here.
Okay. I think it's great that we have this opportunity, but I think it's the absolute wrong place to do it. I think we need to take our time and find a better place to do it.
I guess all I'd say. Thanks, Scott. Can I answer any questions that are needed? Am I allowed to answer any questions about stormwater?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Real quick, just to talk about stormwater. State of Ohio requires that if we are going to be abutting a state highway, any route, county road, we have to keep as much stormwater on our property as required in accordance with 100-year floods, I believe. It's what my engineer ends up telling me. I put a lot of faith in, of course, he's a state of Ohio licensed engineer. On our current site design here, one of the two, you can see a very large detention basin right here at the front of the site.
Seems like you're talking to me.
Yes, right here. So there's a very large detention basin. You can tell it's, you know, about as almost what, half size of that store right there. So that's where all the...
Think it would have held all that, the last little inch and a half rain we had?
Now, is this in your front yard?
Backyard.
Backyard?
Right across the road.
The whole block.
Where's my house in this picture? Okay. That's the only thing I was trying to...
And I don't know how it would affect your back, there will be no net change to you, is what the state code requires. We built it so any water coming off that hill, that naturally articulated, plus our impervious area, has no net change. So this has been a problem, not saying we're gonna be able to fix the problem, but it's going to remain, we're not gonna make the problem worse according to what our state engineer has to do.
I talked to the county...
Can I get copies of those?
Ditch engineer, and they was shocked that nobody had been to talk to them yet about this, and we're in the process of maybe petitioning a ditch job to fix that hole in the town.
Exactly, because every time the field floods, it goes straight into my basement.
So it'd be easier to fix it all.
You know, I ran to replace a furnace and a washer and a dryer, I'm just saying.
Anyone that hasn't spoke wish to speak? Okay, that concludes the public portion. Okay. Does our solicitor have any input for us?
I do not.
Opening up for discussion with the board.
I have a question, Mr. Shear. When, first of all, I think everyone in the community welcomes your approach of bringing a Dollar General to town. You know, we're all supporting that, I would think. My question is, of the properties that you've looked at, which are already zoned business, have you exhausted that?
Well, we looked at the hard intersection downtown. It's too small. That was my number one site when I first came. I'd love to have one right there, but we need over an acre. And as you can tell here, we need nearly two to keep our stormwater on our property. We've gone north. Dollar General didn't want to be up there. They want this
site. And that's not within the corporation.
Gotcha.
At this point. So, those are the only available properties that are zoned?
We also looked south by the ball field.
Okay.
We actually even took into account the fact that you are looking at acquiring some of that land down there in order to expand your park. Wasn't sure if that's privy to this, but so we were making accounts for that in our initial layout. But those negotiations fell out. The road tapers there, makes it harder for turning radius for vehicles coming and going. Dollar General didn't care for that.
So the properties that are zoned business east of town, we've got a gas station, we've got the Lions Club, the defunct grocery store. It's quite a bit of business zoned property in that end of town.
Is the defunct grocery store the auto car sales lot?
Yeah.
Yeah, that gentleman's a haver, I'll tell you what.
What about the property east and west of the Lions Club? Have you looked at that?
Without looking at my notes in front of me, I'm not sure which negotiations landed on
you
that one.
You didn't have enough frontage.
Was that the one?
On the west side.
Okay.
The reason I ask is because I think those are zoned agricultural also.
Okay.
Yet they are kind of in a business district.
Mm-hmm.
Just wondered if you had looked at that.
I believe I've scoured the town quite a bit. I was actually first visited here in early to mid-November. And it's taken me this far to come up with a site. And that Dollar General was found acceptable. So this is the one they really wished me to push forward with. And as you can tell, we've already started doing our best in order to make a good presentation with stormwater and site plans so everyone sees what the layout would be.
In your effort of investigating really seriously and hard, you can't remember east or west of the Lions Club?
One second.
Yeah.
between the properties. While he's looking, did anybody approach the trustees about that piece of ground between Coyotes and the gas station?
I didn't.
That is the ultimate place for this store, folks. Yes.
I think the fire department.
Yes, trustees, township.
So here's the
North of town, at the Dollar General.
This is fire department here? So that was the fire department.
There you go.
We looked as far as the fire department. After that, we went too far out of town.
I see. Well, I want to compliment you on your effort and your presentation.
Thank you, sir.
So if you picked another location, I mean, would you be willing to look at those locations? Or do you
I don't believe Dollar General is willing to look at another location at this time. We haven't executed a lease with Dollar General. They have made a financial commitment to come here, and we've made a financial commitment in our site design. We're also fairly long on our way ourselves. We've surveyed the property, done soil testing phase ones. We may have put the cart before the horse a little bit here, it's possible, but we also want to make an effort to get this open for you all as soon as possible. Dollar General, I live next to one in Hopedale. It's 10 feet from my front yard. It's right there. We actually ended up buying a piece of property with a house on it. Kept the house by shifting to Dollar General. But we'd sure like it to be open by Thanksgiving. It's always nice when you need those products to run down there. So that's our goal, and we have done every effort we can so far to go ahead and make that happen.
So it's this location or pretty much nothing?
For the time being.
Yes.
So is your timeline why corners are being cut then, probably, on the zoning, that you're trying to meet their timeline so that they still
Not deliberately trying to cut any corners that I'm aware of or anything.
I don't have...
We're going by our attorney's recommendation on how we run the meeting, how we do the notifications.
Do you want a copy of the revised code?
I have to rely on my attorney.
I can get it to him.
I would imagine you're talking about 713.
Yes, sir.
Have it.
I have a question that really doesn't deal with you, but it is to you, the zoning. Now, your posting states the two parcels are, and I'll just list the last three numbers because those are the difference, the 801 and the 400, and one is the front parcel, mm-hmm. which is square, but it's also going into the second parcel, but the zoning is calling for the whole entire field on your map?
No, only the 1.4.
So you're going to plat off part of, because on the property tax, that is in those pictures, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. There's only two plots right now, you guys. Okay. That's the one, and this is where basically, I don't know if I'm correct. But there's two parcels there, and the zoning paper says that you're asking to rezone this whole
8 acres.
The two plots, which is 6 point,
that
which,
would be,
I mean, I'm just questioning, right, because no. See, then what you and Fred both told Brian and I that this didn't affect us.
And
but
we
that,
would not be getting the written letter because we were not contingent.
But that would, because it
however,
does run
he rezoned
all
that
8 acres.
We
so I'm curious.
Have 1,500
we absolutely
feet
are not
contingent.
Okay,
eight
that's
eight
all I wanted to clarify, which
right.
had nothing to do with you guys.
Right. This is only for the 1.4.
Okay.
Acres,
and I understand you have
the
plaque and I get that. Because
yeah.
we have nothing against growing this town.
Sure.
It needs
sure.
to
be done correctly.
But yeah, we just want to make sure that it's not something that is.
And if the way, if it is rezoned the way the advertisements were stated, and it lists those two parcel numbers, that that's what this meeting is about. If those two parcel numbers are rezoned and not to an actual developed plat, then I am 100% against a zoning change, because it affect, I just put $200,000 into my house. I have 1,500 feet of frontage abutting that 8 acres. It runs completely around two sides. I will invest a ton of money to stop that 8 acres from being rezoned.
Yeah, that is not the intent at all.
That's not the intent.
How would we clarify, you know, the portion that they're wanting is within the boundaries of these two parcels. They're plopping off a section out of those two parcels. It has not yet been deeded over, has not been...
What you're asking is, I think what you're asking is, whether or not we're talking about rezoning that whole section of land.
Right.
Now, if they're going to build on it, but the question becomes, you know, that section of land. And if you wish to have a discussion, I'll be happy to go into executive session on the legal issue of that.
Well, the way this is presented would be incorrect. Okay, so when we go into executive session, we'll discuss it.
Yes, I think we should. I'll make a motion to go into executive session.
Okay.
Second.
Roll call.
Hold on a second. Neely. Con.
Yes.
Miller.
Yes.
Johnson.
Yes.
Kaufman.
Yes.
Earl. Yes. Right now.
Okay.